Hello friends, welcome to the channel Lightning Mind, and in this session we are continuing with the discussion on the configuration of 6MD663 Siemens MiG BCO using Dixie4 software. Till now we have already discussed how to configure double point signals, how to configure single point signals, how to create CFC logics. Also we have discussed about the creation of interlock logics and then the linking of those interlock into the commands of the breakers, isolator, etc. We have also discussed about the 61850 configuration of 6MD663 BCO and the linking of counters with the command signals. In this session we will discuss about some of the settings related with Siemens BCO, and specifically the settings of auto reclosure and check sync. So if you have already subscribed to this channel, then hopefully you might be aware of all these concepts by practicing the last 4 or 5 sessions that we have covered till now. If you are new to this channel, then you may subscribe this channel if you like the content of this channel. And we generally publish the video in both Hindi as well as English language, and you can select the video as per your convenience from the playlist. All the videos are available in both the language, and we cover the theoretical sessions first, followed by the practical implementations using modern numerical protective relays. And in this series of lecture, basically we have already covered the 7SA522, that is Siemens distance protection relay configuration using Dixie4, and now we are continuing, and probably we are heading towards our last session of Siemens BCO configuration. In this session we are going to discuss the settings, and in the last session we have already discussed the graphic display, wherein we have discussed about the default and control display, how to draw, how to link the commands. So now, without wasting further time, let us start with today's topic. And as you can see on the screen, this is the same project which we are using since last couple of sessions. And till now, you already know that we have to go to settings, and inside the settings, we have already covered device configuration, masking IO, default display, control display, CFC. And now in today's session, we will start with power system data 1. Inside power system data 1, generally the voltage and current of the primary and secondary of CVT and CT are required to be entered, and this depend upon your system. For example, suppose in my case this is 400 kV by 110 volt CVT, and the CT ratio is 2000 by 1, and suppose the rated frequency is 50 hertz. The another important setting is breaker. Inside the breaker you will see two settings. One is the minimum trip command duration, and second is the maximum close command duration. By default these settings are 100 milliseconds for tripping as well as for closing, and you may change this setting if required. But the 100 millisecond is more than enough for breaker closing and breaker tripping purpose. Now we will move to the second settings, which are inside the setting group A. Inside the setting group A, first setting is in the power system data 2. If you see, the first setting inside the power system data 2 is pole open current threshold. What is the meaning of pole open current threshold is, if the current measured by your BCU falls below this level of pole open current threshold, then the BCU will determine or will detect it as the breaker open condition. Suppose your primary rated current is 2000 ampere and the setting is 0.1. So if in the primary circuit the current is less than 200, or if the BCU measures the current which is less than 200 ampere in the primary, then it will detect it as a breaker open condition. So now this pole open current threshold, it is very very important for resetting of trip command, which I have already discussed in detail during the 7SA522 series. So I am not going to go that much deeper now. The only thing is that for reset of trip command, there are two settings available in the BCU. One is your with pole open current threshold only, and second I think with CB aux and pole current threshold. So this is with CB aux and pole open current threshold. So with the first setting, this if your current falls below this setting of suppose 0.1 ampere secondary or 200 ampere primary for this particular case, then only your trip command will reset. So even if suppose your circuit breaker opens, but the current is suppose more than 200 ampere, so your tripping command will not reset. And this is very important, because if you are using this BCU suppose for auto disclosure purpose and your circuit breaker is open, but your current doesn't falls below 200 ampere. So now if you are going to give the closing command, the breaker will not close because trip command is already persisting and your auto disclosure cycle will fail. So this is important. So you can also set with CB aux and pole open threshold, but this is not desirable because if you see here, this is AND logic. So in case of AND logic, you have to satisfy not two conditions. First, inside the masking, your breaker status should come correctly, and then the pole current threshold also. But the breaker status, if you are depending your reset of trip command on the status of breaker, then it is not desirable, because generally for all protection systems, we tends to avoid the dependency of protection system on the switchgear status. Now the next thing is auto reclosure. So inside the auto reclosure, the first important thing is that you have to keep the setting on, auto reclosure function, and the some of the important settings available here are this CB ready interrogation at first trip. So when suppose the fault, the protection relay has detected the fault and it has issued the trip command to your circuit breaker. So now the BCU will check that your CB is ready or not for the auto disclosure cycle. And from where the, this checks it is from this masking IO. If you see in the masking IO power system data 2, I have already assigned suppose one binary input. This binary input, this is CB ready for reclosing. And now this CB ready for reclosing binary input, it depends upon your scheme. Suppose in your scheme, this CB ready depends upon the healthiness of SF6 pressure, the spring charge, the air pressure, if it is pneumatic circuit breaker. So it checks each and every conditions, and then it will issue a positive DC to your masking IO, and that input will get activated and it will make your CB ready. So if your CB is ready at the first trip, then only your auto closure cycle will start. Generally, you can set this as yes or no depending upon your requirement, depending upon your scheme. Now the important thing is evolving fault and the decision that BCU should take during the evolving fault. What is the meaning of evolving fault? First of all, suppose there is a signal phase to ground fault, transient R phase to ground fault in your system, and now within the dead time of suppose 1 second, this fault changes from R phase to ground to suppose RY to ground, or suppose Y phase to ground, anything. So now this fault is changing from one set, that is suppose R phase to ground to Y phase or RY. So it is changing. So these type of faults are known as evolving fault. And in case of evolving fault, you can decide whether your relay will detect it from trip or from pickup. And the important thing is during the evolving fault, what you want your relay to do, whether you want your relay to start 3-pole auto reclosure cycle or block auto reclosure cycle. Generally in transmission system, we block auto reclosure. And then the important thing is your close command via control device. Here you have to link your circuit breaker for which it is issuing the close command. So breaker is this CB open close. Then you have to move to this first AR cycle. In the first AR cycle, only thing that you have to check is check this start of AR allowed in this cycle is yes. And this action time is not required. I will explain what is the meaning of action time. The important thing for us is dead time after 3-pole trip. I think I have selected some incorrect auto reclosure in the device configuration. So this is just go to device configuration, and now single pole trip permitted. So I have to select this as 1 and 3-pole, and then 1 AR cycle. So now I think it will come inside the settings. So go to settings and pole, and now you see dead time after single pole trip. So suppose the setting is 1 second, so select this as 1 second. If you want 3-pole auto reclosure also, then you can have this setting, but generally I don't want this setting for this particular case. But if you want, you can have this setting also, depending upon your company policy, depending upon your utilities policy. Now the next thing is CB ready interrogation before reclosing. This is again the same thing. The BCU will check the CB ready signals through the masking IO. If the CB is ready before reclosing, then only it will issue a closing command. Otherwise, it will issue a outer closure block or three-fold trip. So you have to select it as yes or no depending upon your requirement. Then the three-pole trip deadline closure or reduced dead time. This you can select depending upon your scheme. The important thing is three-pole trip by outer closure, you have to keep it as no if the pole discrepancy relay are available in your substation in your scheme. If pole discrepancy relay is not available, then you must select it as yes. But generally, pole discrepancy relay are provided in all the substation, in all the transmission utilities, so you have to keep this as no. If you keep this as yes, what happens is during the auto reclosure time, your BCU will issue three-pole tripping command, and now the auto reclosure cycle will not complete because it will block. Depending upon what logic you are implemented, it might issue three-pole auto reclosure, but generally for transmission system, once it trip three-pole, it will block auto reclosure. So then apply, okay. Next you have to go to the synchronization functions in the only one setting left here is the measurement supervision. As a measurement supervision, the setting is for voltage failure supervision or VT fuse fail. I have already discussed in detail during 7SA522 series the voltage fuse failure. It is it will be detected based upon current supervision. So suppose in your circuit current is flowing above your normal rated current, or suppose more than pole open current threshold. Generally the current supervision means more than pole open current threshold. So suppose the current is flowing, pole open current threshold setting is suppose 0.1 and current is flowing 0.11 ampere. So now in that case, if suppose your voltage drops less than the your setting value, suppose this maximum voltage threshold, suppose this is 45, and now your voltage drops below 45, so relay will detect it as, or BCU will detect it as voltage fuse failure, and you will get a signal after 3 seconds. So apply, okay, and next we will move to the synchronization function. So in case of synchronization, presently there is no settings available, maybe due to problem in device configuration. So go to device configuration. Yes, all synchronization function is disabled. I will select one. So select enable, okay, and now go to the synchronization function. If you open synchronization function group one, the important setting over here is your general. In the general, the first of all, what you have to do is synchronizable switching device, which device you want for synchronization operation, that is CB. So first select this. Now, minimum voltage for synchronization and maximum voltage for synchronization, this again depends upon your system condition. This depends upon the varies from utility to utility, vary from substation to substation also. So this you have to set as per the setting guidelines of your utility, as per the setting guidelines of your company. The important thing over here is voltage threshold for deadline and dead bus. This is very, very important settings. Suppose presently I have setting of minimum voltage for synchronization as 90 volt and maximum voltage for synchronization as 110 volt. So if your voltage is suppose below 90 volt, then it will not allow for your synchronization or not allow for bracket closing. At the same time, if voltage is more than 110 volt, then also it will not allow for synchronized opening or synchronized closing. Now, suppose this is your deadline dead bus condition. So deadline means suppose you have taken the shutdown of your transmission line. So once you have taken the shutdown of transmission line, theoretically your voltage should come down to zero. But generally, practically it doesn't come to zero, but it will be suppose 20 kV or 30 kV for a 400 kV line. Now that 20 kV or 30 kV, it comes from the induction voltage. So you cannot keep this deadline dead bus voltage at zero. You have to give some minimum value. So suppose this is a minimum of 5 volt. So in case your voltage, induction voltage is less than 5 volt, then it's okay. So the BCU will detect is at deadline. And now when you issue a closing command, it will extend the closing command to circuit breaker. But suppose your induction voltage is coming in terms of secondary as 8 volt. Now what happens, that 8 volt is more than your deadline or dead bus condition. So first thing, now the BCU will not detect it as a deadline dead bus condition. So what it will check now, whether this voltage is more than your minimum voltage requirement. But that voltage, suppose it is 20 volt, so that 20 is not more than that 90. So the BCU now detect that the line or bus is not in the dead condition, but your minimum voltage is less than the setting of minimum voltage, so it will not extend the tripping closing command of circuit breaker, so the synchronization will not happen. And this generally happens whenever you take the shutdown of your transmission line or shutdown of your substation bus, and when you are charging the first breaker, it generally happens that the BCU will not extend the closing command, and that is because of the induction voltage. So you have to set this voltage as per your system condition, and this will come from experience, this will come from past experience, that what are the minimum voltage and minimum induction voltage available in your system. Now the three important thing, this is your conditions for deadline dead bus, live line dead bus, live bus deadline conditions. These two voltages, incoming voltages and the voltage of the bus. So this, suppose U1, U2 are suppose the line voltage and bus voltage. So now U1 greater than means the live line and U2 less than means dead bus. This will be your dead line live bus, and this is your dead line dead bus. So only three conditions are possible, and you want your circuit breaker to issue synchronization command for all these conditions. So you have to keep this yes for all three conditions. The next thing, maximum duration of synchronous check. So it will be depending upon your system, you can keep it as 5, 10 or 30 seconds. So suppose I am taking this as 20 seconds. So now once you issue a closing command to your circuit breaker, so circuit breaker will check for all the conditions that you have set in your settings, and if within that 20 second all the conditions are met, it will extend the closing command, otherwise it will not extend a closing command. Now the minimum frequency and maximum frequency, this again depends upon the settings of your substation. So now move to the sync conditions. So sync conditions, now you will have three different conditions. One is your frequency difference, second is voltage difference, and third is your angle difference. So now for your frequency difference, suppose this setting is for this particular case, suppose the setting is 10 millihertz or 0.01 hertz or 0.1 hertz. So now what happens in that condition, suppose the one frequency is 49.9 hertz, if the second frequency is 50 or 49.8, then only your BCU will allow the synchronization closing of circuit breaker, otherwise it will not allow. Similarly for your voltages, you can have different settings based upon your condition and then the angle difference. So these are the three settings that are, those are available inside Siemens BCU, and this you can set depending upon the settings available for your utility. Now the same way you can set for asynchronization conditions only, also for maximum voltage difference and maximum frequency difference. So these are some of the basic settings that are available inside Siemens BCU. I have discussed only about the meaning of these settings. I have not discussed what settings you have to keep, because that depends upon substation to substation, utility to utility, and country to country. So I am not going to discuss what are the minimum settings that are required to keep. That will change from your organization to my organization. So hopefully whatever concepts are explained in this session are clear to you. We will meet again with some other topic, with some other session shortly. And I hope whatever are explained in this session and in the earlier sessions are clear, and you will practice with the Dixie software on your own. And if you practice, all the concepts will become clear. So if you like the content, then you may subscribe this channel if you have not subscribed till now. And if you have already subscribed this channel, then if you like these contents, then you may share this video with your friends, so that more and more people gets aware about these concepts, and then they may also implement these things at their substation for the betterment. Now if you doesn't like the content, then also you can comment in the comment section, so that based upon the feedback received from your side, I will try to improve upon from our next session onwards. So till now, thank you and goodbye.